Okay, good afternoon, Maria. Thank you very much for joining this interview. So, you've been Dean of Faculty of International Liberal Arts at Soka University, Japan, from April 2013. Is that correct?
Well, actually, we admitted our first class in April of this year,
okay.
2014.
Okay.
So we accepted 80 students who began in an all-English curriculum.
Sure, fantastic. And also you had an experience as a trustee at Soka University of America. How long for?
Since we opened our doors 2001, so it's been over 13 years now.
And also you had an experience as national speaker and trainer. What is all about?
Well, I wanted to be able to lend my voice around issues of culture, leadership, and excellence.
Fantastic. So you have a great experience in the field of education. So let's get to the first question.
Okay.
The Faculty of International Liberal Arts in Soka University of Japan is a great challenge. It's been recently inaugurated. And how do you feel about that? What are the major experiences that you want to share with educators in Italy?
I think the most important thing is to share with you that our mission is to raise the next generation of global leaders. So how do we do that? How do we take young students and really imbue in them a sense of mission towards contributing to issues worldwide?
Sure. Well, that's a great mission. And on the top of that, all the classes are taught in English.
All of the classes are in English, and our students, very different than any other university, our students are asked to take one full academic year in study abroad.
Okay, that's fantastic. So in total, how many students do you have in the faculty, in the FILA, which is Faculty of International Liberal Arts?
Yes, so in our new faculty, we have 80 students.
Mm-hmm.
10 of them are international.
Okay.
So the majority of our students are Japanese.
Wow.
But all of them are required to go study abroad for 1 year.
Okay, and so let's say the majority of the students to date are Japanese students.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of challenges do they have in kind of trying to speak the English language and writing and then listening and then being taught by native speakers and so on? What kind of challenges?
Well, as you can imagine, learning happens, yes, in the classroom, because it is all English medium instruction.
Mm-hmm.
But I believe learning, just as much learning happens outside of the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
So our job has been to create a living and learning community that really supports students inside the classroom and outside the classroom.
Fantastic. So this is Soka University, and the name Soka, of course, has a profound meaning. What does mean Soka to you? If you, let's say, three main points. Why Soka University? Why FILA is different from other universities?
Well, I think the agreed upon understanding is value creation. But the heart of the matter is, how do you operationalize that when it comes to student teaching and learning? What happens in the classroom?
That's right, that's right.
What happens in relationships between students, between faculty members and students? For me, Soka value creating at a university is about truly, truly fostering, discovering that potential that every student has. And that's what the founder of Soka University established for us. Our motto or tagline at the university is discovering your potential.
That's right. That's
we
right.
take that very seriously. So every
I know that.
Every student has tremendous potential.
That's right.
And truly the job of a professor is to uncover that and pull it out, to really allow the student to discover what their future contribution can be in the world.
Fantastic. So you are the dean of FILA faculty, but you're also teaching. What is your teaching philosophy?
I had the great privilege and pleasure of teaching humanistic education last semester. Next semester, I'll be teaching Soka education.
Fantastic.
And for me, the opportunity to be the facilitator in a classroom, that is what I believe the job of a professor is. It's to facilitate learning. It's to allow students to discover the joy of learning so that, in fact, they will become lifelong learners. If I can do that as a professor, I feel like I've accomplished my job.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic. So thank you so much for sharing this. And what about your experience at Soka University of America? What kind of commonalities between the two universities? It's a kind of sister university, right?
True.
They have a kind of connection, and I'd like to say a profound connection.
Well, certainly the founder mm-hmm. is the connection that ties the two universities together.
Sure.
And while our founding principles are slightly different at both universities, at the end of the day, it's about allowing students to contribute to the world. That, to me, is the commonality. It's about creating a learning environment that supports student learning. I believe the most important person at a university is not the president or board members or even faculty members. It's the students. That is so good education.
Fantastic. And this ties in a way, well, you kind of, from time to time, talking about humanistic leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And you join also conferences and gave speeches about humanistic leadership. What is humanistic leadership? Because this is a very interesting concept, especially for the future.
Yes. So the world needs leaders. The world needs individuals who will guide us as humanity. For me, humanistic leadership is a leadership that is based on three principles: compassion, wisdom, and courage. It's a leader who will take those three factors and truly provide guidance for those that person works with.
Sure.
It's someone who respects every human being and at the same time has a vision that allows others to follow.
Fantastic. And lastly, a short message to the educators in Italy. They are looking forward to watch your kind of interview. In Italy, of course, we don't have Soka institutions at the moment, but we are working hard toward that goal. And you experienced it, Soka University of America, since the very beginning. What kind of efforts you did at that time, together with the other staff members and the students? What kind of determination is needed in order to, let's say, contributes to an institution, to a Soka institution?
I would say that every teacher is a Soka educator. Every teacher can be a Soka educator. You don't need an elementary school or a university founded by Daisaku Ikeda. I believe that every teacher has the ability to live and breathe Soka education.
Mm-hmm.
And fundamentally, it means believing and respecting
mm-hmm.
in the incredible potential of every one of your students.
That's right.
I'm very happy to know that there are Italian educators who I believe are following in this tradition,
mm-hmm.
a very important tradition, that if they can contribute their wisdom, their courage and their compassion, they will in fact be contributing to the creation of the next generation.
That's right, that's right. And how about, that's absolutely a precious vision we're talking about, is teaching with the very heart of Soka, kind of as a Soka educators, right? But then when it comes to establish an institution, I'm sure that when you were in the United States and you first started to work at the very beginning of the foundation, the establishment of Soka University of America, you had kind of challenges in terms of teaching students and coordinating all the, I'm just guessing because I was not there.
Well, all of that happened. And I think that what encouraged many of us is something that the founder has said.
Mm-hmm.
And he was talking recently about passion.
Mm-hmm.
And he said that the origin of the word comes from Latin.
Mm-hmm.
And origin actually means to struggle. And so he says true passion is when you are willing to struggle to overcome any obstacle, to have the courage to face every struggle, every hardship.
Sure.
So I think that at Soka University of America, in classrooms every day, our teachers face struggle.
Mm-hmm.
But with passion, as educators, following the founder's words, we can overcome. We can overcome that challenge and truly be victors and contribute and fulfill our mission as teachers.
Fantastic. Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
A last message to the Italian educators.
Hello, and I'm sorry I'm not there with you, but I wish you all the best.
Thank you very much.